Did you always enjoy drawing when growing up? I didn't really think about the enjoyment part when I was a child. When meeting my friends at later stage, that I noticed that everyone did not draw. I thought everyone did it, so it was more a surprise. The enjoyment part is something that I recognize as an adult. I didn't think about it when I was a child. What is your average day like? Not to sound too dramatic, but I see your life as my dream life. You draw what you enjoy and what resonates inside you and clearly with others. Play with your dog, spend time living and drinking tea with your wife in a good and honest country. I think I will just leave this question because everything I say will probably break the illusion. So yeah, that's more or less my life. Comparing your art now with the past. When I started out and I was young, I seldomly finished my pieces. Nowadays I always finish a piece, and one big difference is when I started out I always wanted to have a complete image in my head prior to starting. I was never completely happy with the result because the image I had in my head and the image that was on the paper was not the same. So nowadays I don't really have the final image in my head, I just start drawing, and that makes the process so much more enjoyable, and I'm always happy with the results. So those are probably the biggest difference to my art when I started out. Where is your favorite place to relax and draw? When traveling is probably the best and most relaxing way for me to find places to draw. Just going to a cafe or maybe a pub, just taking a cup of coffee or maybe a beer and sit down and draw. That is the most relaxing and the most enjoyable place to draw. I try to get into the same feeling when I'm in my studio, but there's something magical when traveling, I think. Key advice to a young artist. One advice to a young artist would be not to listen too much to older artists. Try to find the answers yourself. Do your work reflect your Nordic roots? Yes, I would say it probably does. It's always hard to really get a sense of your own artwork, but I would say that a lot of stuff comes from my childhood, and also perhaps the rather slow tempo of the North, maybe some kind of work ethics, I don't know, but I would say that it's if I was brought up in Asia or in another country, you would probably see a difference to it. Your favorite thing to fill out an empty space in your drawings? Objects that really take up a lot of space, like dinosaurs and elephants, are great because just adding one fills out a large part of a drawing. So when I get tired of completing a drawing, I always tend to add a dinosaur or an elephant. They're great. Growing up, what made you pursue art? I would say that the fact that I did not grow up just left art as the only possible career for me. The only way I could do it was to keep a part of me childish that made it possible for me to be an artist. How many robots does it take to draw one of your drawings? At this moment, still a lot of problem with the robots. We've tried in my lab to make the robots produce drawings, but they still struggle with such simple drawings like circles. But I'm positive that someday all of my drawings will be made with robots, by robots. How many hours a day do you draw? I would say that absolute maximum I can draw is perhaps 8 hours. And after 8 hours, my body really starts to hurt. I try to keep it perhaps between 3 hours and 8 hours. Yeah, that's more or less it. Which illustrators from your childhood has inspired you? Well, the Finnish illustrator and author Tove Jansson, one great influence from my childhood. I loved her books and I loved her illustration, and most of all I loved her comics. They are so full of humor and spirit, and she also created her own universe, and that's something I always aim towards. And then also Rickard Skäris books. A lot of stuff happening, and a Swedish illustrator from the beginning of the 20th century called Oscar Andersson. Some really, really early comics, and a Norwegian illustrator called Kjell Åkrust also. Do you prefer making art for yourself or for business? I prefer making my own stuff. In the future, I would probably prefer just to make my own material. On occasion, when the collaboration works really good, it's nice to be part of something other than only yourself. So a little of each world is probably the best combination. Do you always wear those boots? No, actually, I don't own a pair of cowboy boots. I just find them highly amusing. So it's more the thought of a character wearing those rather extravagant boots. It just makes me happy.